All right, we're using Google Sheets and we just made a little table of data here. And what we want to do is we want to just come up with a total price. So essentially what you would do is take the quantity in cell D9, multiply it by E9, and then repeat that on each row. So let's just come in row 9 and we're going to do that the simple way, which is D9 times E9. And we'll hit enter and it's 897. So Google Sheets was smart enough to suggest that I fill this all the way down. Let's do that. And whether this is 4 rows or 100 rows, it's not very hard to copy it down. But a more durable way to do this and that to avoid future mistakes where someone might come in here, accidentally delete a row, or maybe you add a row later, forget to put the formula in, lots of different things that can happen. We're going to delete all of these formulas and start over and show you a completely different way to do this. We're going to use a function called an array formula. And what an array formula does is it will take what you give it and repeat it for the entire range that you specify. All right, so we're going to take that original formula, which was D9 times E9, and instead of saying D9, we're going to take this entire column. And in this case, we'll take the ending row off of it, just in case we add items later, it'll catch everything. So it'll start at D9 and go all the way down to the bottom of your spreadsheet. And then we're going to multiply each of those cells by the corresponding values in column E. It needs to be the same range in order for this logic to work. So it's E9 all the way down to the bottom of E. And you're done with this array formula. So you close it off and you hit enter. And it wrote the values into all of these cells below it, but there's no formulas here. It's all dynamically written by what you put into cell F9. Now, the way I wrote that's the safest way to make sure you capture all the rows, but I actually think it's kind of ugly, so I'm going to switch it back to give it a floor here, D9 to D12, E9 to E12, and it just looks a little bit prettier. You can expand this and use the array formula inside of other logic. So let's say we want to do an average of the total price. So what we'll do, we will copy this formula. We'll use it all except the equal sign. And we'll come one cell to the right, hit the equal sign, and we're going to average, open up the parentheses, and then we'll paste that array formula in and then close it off. Okay, so that formula has used the array formula to create an average, and this new feature in Google Sheets can be very helpful, but in this case, no, I don't want to autofill that because it only makes sense once, so we're going to click off of that. But what we've done here is build two resilient formulas that will pick up changes. So I change this 4 to a 10, everything updates, but it's only built on two different formulas. And here's another advantage of using it as a second level, what I'm calling it, which is really just nested inside of this function. Whereas if I delete column F, this function still works because it started over, it has its own array formula inside of it. So next up, we're going to look at a function that will take a long table of data, probably one longer than this, look through it and return, let's say the top 5 unique values or the bottom 4 unique values. Grab all the columns that you want, and it will work like this function too, where it's dynamically written and it only sits in one cell. So it's the unique function. Let's check out that video next.